This is a mistake that many mathematicians do all the time, simply because it makes sense to do it, until it doesn't. 2 is not equal to 4, 3 is not equal to 9, 4 is not equal to 16, 5 is not equal to 25, and we don't expect any x become equal to x2 in this series. Therefore, we can say that these values are not equal. So, it doesn't make sense to assume infinity is equal to infinity. This assumption will be a mistake. Assuming that infinity cannot be equal to infinity is a mistake too. Here, we can easily see that infinity can be equal to infinity. And the big question is, when infinity equal infinity is satisfied, and how we can solve this equation? Can we develop a new math tool to prove the Riemann hypothesis? But before exploring the application of this mistake on Riemann hypothesis, let's list the known indeterminate forms. Every time we encounter this form, we must carefully examine them at their limit to find a solution. These two equations give us enough reason to add infinity equal to infinity to the indeterminate forms. So every time we encounter this form, we must carefully examine this new form at its limit to find a solution. This is the definition of the derivative, which later becomes an essential part of mathematics known as calculus. So the solution to 0 divided by 0 gave us calculus. The question is, what infinity equal to infinity can give us? Can this new indeterminate form help us to invent a new mathematical tool to prove the Riemann hypothesis? Let's see how we can connect this new indeterminate form to the Riemann hypothesis. And if you're not familiar with the Riemann hypothesis, I highly recommend watching the videos that I will list them shortly in order, and I promise you will have a good understanding of the Riemann hypothesis, why the Riemann hypothesis is so important, and how difficult it is to prove the Riemann hypothesis after watching these videos. Also, I believe these golden notes transcend the meaning of these videos to another level.
One of the great unsolved problems in mathematics.
A puzzling conundrum.
And there are whole books written assuming the truth of the Riemann hypothesis.
Hard to believe, yet it is
true. The most difficult way to earn $1 million.
I would say an insane way.
Haunted people like me for 150 years.
Notoriously hard problem.
Tools are not there. It doesn't matter how smart or quick you are.
So you see that we need a new tool to prove the Riemann hypothesis, simply because all attempts to prove the Riemann hypothesis with the current math have been unfruitful effort. Okay, let's define a simple function and use it to connect the Riemann hypothesis to the new indeterminate form. There is some sharp mathematics behind this function. But for sake of this video, assume we define this function with a characteristic that we want. This function has two variables, n and s. S is a complex number with a real part of 1 minus s, or s between 0 and 1. And n can be any natural number. Please note that the limit of n to infinity of this function is equal to infinity, as you can see. This is Riemann's zeta function, and we know that it is equal to infinity where the real part of s is between 0 and 1. In other words, this simplest form of zeta function is equal to infinity in the critical strip. We are almost there. Now we are ready to to create an indeterminate form with these two functions. Notice the connection between the real part of s of this function and real part of 1 minus s of this function to 1/2. Now the question is, when this equality is satisfied? In other words, what are the solutions for this indeterminate form? It is possible to prove the solution to this indeterminate form are identical to the solution to the analytic continuation of the zeta function equal to zero. And we know that the Riemann hypothesis is related to the zero of the zeta function and the real part of s equal 1/2. We saw the deep connection between infinity equal infinity and the Riemann hypothesis. But why this new indeterminate form is a game changer for the Riemann hypothesis? As you see, the analytic continuation functions are often messy. Also, notice that it is impossible to integrate these functions. So difficult indeed that Riemann himself couldn't integrate his functions. Now should be easy to see how this new indeterminate form simplifies Riemann hypothesis to the simplest zeta function and a super simple function with one term only. And if we prove something for blue functions, it will apply to the red function for the zero of the zeta functions. The goal of this video is not to show how to prove the Riemann hypothesis. The goal was to show that this new indeterminate form is a promising tool to prove the Riemann hypothesis. And here is the bonus point. The solution to 0 equal to 0 led us to invent the algebra. The search for the solution to 0 divided by 0 gave us calculus. We know the importance of the solution to this limit and its corresponding indeterminate forms. In this video, we defined a new indeterminate form that could replace difficult problems like Riemann hypothesis with much easier problem. The question is, what the search for a complete or partial solution to infinity equal infinity can give us? And more important question is, what are the hidden potentials of the Riemann hypothesis and this new tool? Please like and subscribe, and please keep in mind that the spot for another math superstar and his or her masterpiece is open. This video is dedicated to these infinite superstars. Thank you very much for watching, liking, subscribing, and commenting. Please comment Riemann's last theorem, or RSLT in short, or singularity if you like to see a video regarding these topics. Have a great time.